What's up, guys? This is Who's Bubble, and I just want to tell you, our merch hasn't got many sales, but you're gonna buy it right now, right? Link in the description, go check out our merch, buy it. Also, guys, we have a brand new Trio Gaming channel where we play games of all sorts, starting off with Gmod and old videos on there, so go check it out right now, smash like and subscribe, and let's get on with this great episode. From Anchor, the Trio Podcast starring Bubble and Curves. This is Bubble along Mr. Curves and the Trio Orchestra. Invite you to join the trio. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the trio! Welcome to the Trio Podcast, episode 23, also known as the number Kobe Bryant wears.
You said Kobe Bryant again, you dumb idiot!
And Michael Jordan and Michael LeBron Jordan, James.
Kobe's 24.
Hey! 24. You know, Michael Jordan.
I messed it up three times in a row.
Michael Jordan wears number 23. Okay, that's all that matters.
I doubt that. I'm good.
Hey, that's everybody knows that. You know that?
I see him wearing number 6, man. I don't know.
Okay, well, you're wrong.
Okay, he used to wear number 23. Okay.
He always wore that. That's his famous number. But welcome back to the Trio Podcast. What a eventful way to begin. My name is Bubble, alongside Mr. Curbs, and somebody joined our Discord server, known as Huga 2.0. He, looks like his old account got hacked. So if you guys want to join our Discord and talk just like him, link in the description. We need people on our Discord being active, and yeah. So I'm Trio Podcast, episode 23, you know. Last week we talked about our daily activities, our routines, our ice baths. Curbs, do you ice bath?
Have you ice bathed in the last week?
You know, let me just
see exactly, bro. Exactly.
I haven't.
I'm so revolutionary with my ice bath. You're just like, I only do it like once.
Well, I'm trying to tell you the one time I did it, okay? That was the last episode. Check it out. How is it doing an ice bath? I'll tell you how it is. Go watch the last episode. But anyway, welcome to our podcast. Next week, we should have a guest. This week, we're chilling again. But the next coming weeks
are... What are your guests? Comment down below.
Yeah, we should do another poll for what guests you want. So join the Discord so we could do that. And yeah. So, there's a lot of tests for me and Curbs right now. Curbs, how do you think you did on your test so far?
It's alright. You know, it's the end of June. Everybody's taking tests. We're actually in 8th grade, so, you know, we got a lot of big finals coming up.
Facts.
We're 8th graders.
Yeah, okay. But, yeah. Lovely test coming up. The last one for me is on Tuesday. So.
What's the topic for today's episode, man? I think they want to hear about our schoolwork.
Yeah, well, everybody has their school, you know. We try to share experiences here. But we try to give you entertainment. So today we're going to be talking about the Spider-Man movie that just came out. Also known as Spider-Man. What's the title of it? Spider-Man
Into... Across the Spider-Verse.
Across the Spider-Verse. And the first one is Into the Spider-Verse, right?
And then the third one's going to be Beyond the Spider-Verse.
Okay, these dames. This is going to be very tricky to remember.
They changed one word.
But we're going to be reviewing that movie. We saw it. Me, Curves. When did we see it?
A couple weeks ago. Can't give him an exact date because...
Well, it was last week.
No, they're going to hack into the system.
Next week we'll see it. So it wasn't by... It was after last week's episode we saw it. So it was probably the weekend. Last weekend. But... Yeah.
Weeks ago, let's just say that.
We saw this Spider-Man movie. Did you guys see it? Comment down below. We're going to talk all about it.
According to our statistics, most people have clicked off by now, so...
Then we're going to be talking about... we're going to do a tier list of every Spider-Man movie. Then we're going to go through some news. some questions, and then we're going to be peacing out for today. So let's get into this one, this juicy episode, Curbs. So, Curbs, first thoughts about the Spider-Man movie, the first image that comes to mind.
The first image when I think of it?
Yeah.
But definitely, like, the Spider-Man from the future, Spider-Man 2099. I thought he was cool.
Really?
I liked his theme song. Hey. Play the theme song, man. It's a bop.
Dude, the first thing I think of is that guy with the holes. He just was a hole.
Oh, the spot?
Dude, that guy, he just had holes.
So, Bubble, what do you think of the Spider-Man movie?
Well, I think it's a lovely movie. Spoilers, of course, here. So, you know, first off, I was sitting down, you know, enjoying this movie, and all of a sudden I start feeling popcorn hit my head. Why was that? Because my friend started throwing popcorn at me for no reason. I don't know why he would do such a thing.
We're reviewing the movie. We're not reviewing the random guy that started throwing popcorn.
Well, I gotta share my experience here, because...
Okay.
If you guys have this, I'm going to show you how to handle it. So if somebody's throwing popcorn at you in the movie theater, guys, the one thing you must
dump
do
the bucket on their head.
Is dump the entire bucket on top of their head.
Dude,
as return.
Paid for that.
Okay?
For that.
The janitors, you know, they might not be happy, but...
The janitors are like, fuck you. Because you do this every time. Get it for Guardians of Galaxy 3, bro.
People always want to throw popcorn at you.
They know your face, and they're like, fuck that kid.
But, I mean, if you want to throw popcorn at me, you'll see some. Mark Rober actually made a little invention.
You'll see my dark
side. Mark Rober did a video where he, like, made a popcorn, like, thing that falls on you if you're on your phone. It's pretty goofy. But, yeah, don't be on your phones during movies. I definitely wasn't. But, yeah, Curbs, first thoughts of this movie, looking through it. Was it the best Spider-Man movie so far?
Like, ever? I thought it was very good. Animation looked really good. Overall, just a great movie. Except for the end. At the end, I was kind of, like, bummed out.
Yeah, why don't we talk about the end there?
Oh, well, let's talk about your thoughts on the movie.
You know, the ending... Let's just say it ruined the whole movie, guys. Spoilers.
Okay. It didn't ruin the whole movie.
It kind of made it useless, you know?
It kind of felt... The ending made the whole thing just feel lackluster.
It's kind of disappointing when you pay a lot of money to see a movie and then they don't finish the movie, yeah.
That's why you do your research beforehand, buddy, and that's how you find out it's a part two. It's
that's
two
why
part.
You look on Rotten Tomatoes before you see a movie to see if the reviews
okay,
are
okay, but this this movie has a 98 on, like, Rotten Tomatoes.
Yeah, so I have exceptions, okay. But, let's take a look at these reviews here. Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse. Yep. So there's a brand new, Okay, 96% tomato meter and 95 audience. That is one of the best I've seen. Wow. That is so high. Why is that so high? I feel like people should have got mad at it.
Probably because most of them went in knowing it was a two-parter and you were like the only person.
Damn. The audience says, from incredible animations to super story and tons of Easter eggs, it is everything fans could ask for. And
yeah,
then the
movie.
Critics say,
it.
Just as visually dazzling and action-packed as its predecessor, from start to cliffhanger conclusion. So they do give us a little hint. But overall, I feel like it was a great movie. The animations were just out of this world. Out of this verse.
The animations automatically make it like a...
Well, you cut out there. What did you say?
I said your full name and address.
Okay, well.
I think I cut out.
Okay, Curbs, how do you feel about there being, like, billions, if not trillions, or dillions of Spider-Mans?
The fuck's a dillion?
It's a number.
I don't think that's a number.
I just invented a number.
A sextillion amount of Spider-Man.
Dude, do you guys know Dill?
There's a universe out there where Trident is Spider-Man.
Yeah. The big Spider-Man.
Why you gotta do that, man?
I didn't. Okay, well, if Trent's watching, subscribe.
I don't think Trent watches this anymore.
Yeah, I think he does secretly. The top critic says animated Spider-Man sequels worth the price of admission in this 4-star movie. Wow. Another top critic says it's really impressive how this movie has its cake while eating it too. What does that mean?
Damn. All right, well, I think we should move on to the tier list. Fuck these critics.
Well, hold up here. We gotta actually say what happened in this movie for the people who want spoilers, you know?
Want spoilers. We want to be spoiled.
Well, I mean, I would recommend this movie if you want to see a 2-hour, 20-minute long movie with lackluster of unexpected events. I feel like this is a good movie for an 8-year-old to watch.
Okay, the story was, like, really good up until the ending. I feel like once the next one comes out and you watch them back-to-back, it's going to be, like, a perfect story. But, like, I just feel like, you know, the ending sort of leaves it just, like, it, like, builds up to, like, kind of, like, nothing. So, like, once the next movie comes out, it's going to be better.
Yeah, the next one is expected to come out next year. I actually had a substitute in school, and he saw it twice in 1 week. And this guy also broke my teacher's chair.
That guy's like, he's like the size of Trident.
I hope he's not watching. Imagine he's watching this right now.
Oh, the substitute or Trident?
Sub.
Yeah, because he's a fan of us.
So yeah, go check out the movie, guys. It has amazing reviews.
Trident leaving the podcast was a canon event.
You know, it was the fate, bro. So here's a little movie info before we wrap this section up. Miles Morales returns for the next chapter of the Oscar award-winning Spider-Verse saga, an adventure that will transport Brooklyn's full-time friendly neighborhood Spider-Man across the multiverse to join forces with Gwen Stacy and a new team of spider people to face off with a villain more powerful than anything they have ever encountered. Boom. Mr. Holes himself. That's
his name's a spa.
And it's kind of funny how when you first see the movie, this villain is like goofy, and he's in the supermarket, and he's funny, bro. Like,
I thought he was played by like David Spade in the beginning. He sort of sounded like David Spade.
And then all of a sudden, this guy, he became the villain. It was kind of weird, but.
Yeah, it's like a twist villain, you know?
Yeah, you gotta love that. Yeah, you gotta love that.
But I feel like after the whole India scene, he sort of just disappears for the rest of the movie.
Yeah, there's an India Spider-Man, guys. So. But yeah, Curves, are you ready to rank every Spider-Man? There's only like 10.
Yeah.
So,
I think there's actually 11.
Alright, guys, here we are with...
Is that all?
With most, I think all, except the new one we gotta add, right?
Eh, we can add that, like, we can pretend add that, we can pretend.
Alright, so, you know, there's been a bunch of Spider-Man movies across time. We gotta zoom in, though, because I can't read crap. Alright, what is this?
Oh, that's Spider-Man No Way Home.
No Way Home, okay.
Put that in God tier.
Oh, yeah, this one was good. God tier?
Yeah, because it had all three Spider-Man in it. Like, what else could you need?
Oh, man? Yeah, that one. It was that one. Toby himself. You gotta love it, guys. Alright, Far From Home. This one was aight.
This is the one with Mysterio. I thought that one was pretty aight.
It was kind of goofy with the whole drone thing.
You can put it in, like, great.
Great? Is it really great, though? Like,
alright, you can put it in an okay.
Spider-Man.
That's the first ever Toby one. I'd put that in God tier. That's like a really
It's gotta be God tier. I mean, this set the whole franchise up. This is the one with Faithful. Uncle Ben, right?
Yeah. I mean, a lot of them have.
Yeah, if you saw the new Spider-Man, there's like 20. There's everybody has Uncle Ben.
Everybody has an Uncle Ben.
But yeah, this was the cornerstone to every Spider movie following. It was pretty revolutionary. So yeah. Toby got a big paycheck for that one. Goes in God tier. Spider-Man Homecoming.
Honestly, I'm not the biggest fan of this one, just because it feels too Iron Man-y. Like, it feels like more like an Iron Man movie with Spider-Man involved. I put it in, like, mediocre.
What is that supposed to mean, Curbs?
Like, most of it is just, like, involves, like, Iron Man and, like, his tech. And, like, the villain wants to get revenge on Iron Man. He doesn't even care about Spider-Man.
Dude. Where does Spider-Man Homecoming go on this?
Put it mediocre.
Mediocre, dude.
Yeah.
Alright, Spider-Man 2. Oh, Doc Ock, that's me.
That's God tier, honestly. I love that. Spider-Man 2 might even be a little bit
better. God tier, dude. That's insane. Spider-Man 3. The hated but loved at the same time.
It's not as good as the first two. I'd put it in like okay, not bad.
Really? I think it's better than Far From Home, bro. I just think the first three were amazing. You don't think so? Sandman, bro? Yeah. Let's enter Sandman.
Sandman. Alright, the Miles one. You can put that in great movie.
So this is the original one?
Yeah.
Okay. It's a great movie. It had Porky movie. Pig and a bunch of cool characters.
Dude, Porky Pig's returning in the next movie, man.
We didn't expect, so... You know. It was a good twist. And when it first came out, everybody was like, wait, there's a black Spider-Man? So you'll have to see it. But next we got, is this the
I can't tell if that's one or two.
I think it says two on it.
Two? If it's two, then it's like mediocre. That's the one with like Electro that was like.
Alright, I never saw these. Do you recommend it, Cruz?
It was sort of just like mid.
Electro? Isn't that on the ride in Universal?
Yeah, it might be.
Oh, that was a fun ride. Alright, I think he goes an okay, but okay, not bad. Spider-Man, the Amazing Spider-Man, first one.
I put that in a great movie. I thought that movie was pretty good.
Andrew Garfield.
That's the one with Lizard.
Who's in it?
Lizard.
Oh, yeah, I saw bits of that one. The lizard, bro. He's goofy.
Okay.
Venom?
This is... The first one's, like, Venom 2, I think, because it has, like, the other guy. That one's, like... I saw that one. That one was, like, I think the original Venom, the first one, was, like, kind of trash. Like, that movie was, like, just eh. The sequel was a little bit better. So that one's, like, an okay... The first one's like trash.
Meh, kind of trash.
And there you have it, home.
All right, wait, and the new one.
I'd probably put that in great, honestly. I just thought it was. All
right, I would put it with great as well. I mean, it's like the first one basically, except the ending. You know, what'd they have to do at the end there, Cribs, huh? But
have an ending.
Let's screenshot that, and there you go, folks. That is the trio official ranking of the Spider-Man movie.
Actually, the only official ranking, because if you rank them any other way, you're wrong.
That's true.
I just realized we just said Venom 2 was better than Spider-Man Homecoming. Maybe I treated Spider-Man Homecoming a little too quickly.
You know, Spider-Man Homecoming wasn't the best movie, Curbs.
I just thought, like, the first two, like, like, the Avengers universe, Marvel movies were just sort of mid because they just involved Iron Man, like, a lot. Yeah. Like, even in the second one, it had, like, Iron Man's drones. Villain hated Iron Man. It's like, it's a Spider-Man movie, bro.
Well, Curbs, you know what time it is?
What time is it?
It's playing.
Oh.
Welcome back. This is the new segment with the trio. We have some breaking news coming in, Curbs. What is happening today?
I don't know. Set up the new segment so you know. So, what are you asking me for?
This guy does not know what is happening right now in the world.
Oh, fuck.
You gotta know what's happening right now.
But you literally wrote down the news segment.
Donald Trump is heading to jail once again.
Haven't we reported this like 50 times?
I mean, yeah.
Dude, you're not sending a
president.
But
it just keeps happening.
You're not sending a president to jail. You know, he would be like killed on site. He's gonna be like in a special prison.
Well, Cribs, the release day is tomorrow of the brand new Flash movie. Are you excited?
Yeah. It was like supposed to release in like 2018. So it took them like 5 years.
Shall we go see it and review it next week alongside a guest?
Yeah, sure, why not?
Alright, we might go see it. We just gotta plan it out.
Talk about how Ezra Miller gropes kids.
Sunday it is coming out. Tomorrow, actually.
Just bypass that puppy.
Wow, so the Batman is in the Flash movie? I see spoiler images here.
It's not spoilers, that's part of the trailer. It's part of the advertising.
Oh, I didn't see the trailer.
He's literally part of the movie.
You know what? Let's see the trailer right now alongside our...
I don't think we can watch a full trailer on YouTube. I think we get it, like, taken down.
Nah, we've already watched the Freddy Fazbear trailer before.
Get copyright striked for just, like, playing clips of...
Okay. Alright, guys, here is the brand new Flash trailer.
I lost my parents.
This video gets copyrighted. It's on you, man.
That pain.
I can't hear anything.
Made me who I am. I spent a lifetime trying to right the wrongs of the past.
Yo, Batman. Oh, wow.
As if fighting crime would bring my parents back. You actually did it.
Michael Keaton!
I can't imagine what you've been through. I love you, Monkey. You lost both parents in one day.
Nothing bad happens to
you. Call 911 now!
I went back in time to save my parents.
But instead, I completely broke the universe.
If you went back and changed the past,
this world must die.
Change the future.
Do you know what this symbol stands for?
It's a super
hope, right?
Woman.
Yeah. I will help you fight Zod.
You want to get nuts? Let's get nuts.
Is that Batman?
Oh, no, it's just a guy wearing a Batman suit. I think some of the effects kind of look a little weird.
I have to undo what I did.
These scars we have make us who we are. And I'm meant to go back and fix them. Don't let your tragedy define you.
What did you do?
No matter what we do, we're not going to be able to fix this.
No! Nobody dies!
Batman just ate shit.
You're strapped to your parachutes.
And where's yours?
Why is Batman the coolest part of the Flash movie?
The worlds collide in the Flash when Barry uses his superpowers to travel back in time in order to change the events of the past. But when his attempt to save his family alters the future, Barry becomes trapped in a reality in which General Zod has returned, threatening inhalation, and there are no superheroes to turn to. That is unless Barry can coax a very different Batman out of retirement and rescue an imprisoned Kryptonian. Okay. Wow. Pumped for that now. I'm pumped after that trailer.
It's a Flash movie with that is mainly with Batman and has a Superman villain.
So it's basically Spider-Man No Way Home.
Yeah, I guess, but it's not. I mean, unless they bring in Christian Bale. That...
All right, guys, another breaking news story. We have the Flash movie. There's also a new Beatles song coming out. What? That's crazy.
I thought they were dead.
Paul McCartney says artificial intelligence has enabled a final Beatles song. That is pretty crazy, if you ask me. I mean, AI is changing everything. So, AI is going to... Kirby, did you have to say something?
John Lennon. He's dead.
But yeah, we're going to have dead members come back to life with this AI. And you know, we've seen Drake's Foley. It wasn't even Drake, actually. Wasn't it Ice Spice? They made Drake sing the whole song.
They made AI. People are out there making Drake songs. They're just taking Drake AI and they're just making new songs. Brand new songs. And it just sounds exactly like Drake.
Yeah, so, I mean, this technology is really crazy. You know, that's probably going to be the proper way to use it. I mean, that's a good way to use technology. Bringing back music that couldn't be finished. And, you know,
hopefully... Make the Beatles sing Ballin'.
Apple Bottom Jeans by the Beach Boys, bro.
Put the new 4Gs on the Jeep.
Look, guys, it's time for the Trio Mailbag.
We have no mail.
We actually do have mail. We have some questions coming in, Curbs.
No, this is so cap. I've never seen a screenshot.
Hold up, I forgot to end the news segment. That'll do it for the news segment.
My brother, Leonardo, your trash can.
Sorry, we're having a little audio malfunction.
This guy, bro...
How'd they ever add this soundboard? It's so treacherous.
It's time for the mailbag, Curbs. You already know, Curbs. Let's play the music. We got a question coming in. Curbs, we have a question coming in. What are some of the most significant experiences or turning points in your life that have influenced who you are today? Curves?
Yeah, what was the question? I was just waiting for you to finish your sentence.
What are some of the most significant experiences or turning points in your life that have influenced who you are today, Curves?
So when I was younger, my Uncle Ben got shot. And he taught me to great power, great responsibility, and I'm a better man because of it.
Is your name Toby by any chance?
Oh.
So, but what about, actually, though?
I don't think there's any that I would want to share.
Okay. Yeah, that's a tough question. I'm going to have to pass.
Yeah, sort of
Oh, another question we got from the email.
No way!
Can you recall a particular mentor or role model who plays a significant role and influence your life choices and decisions, Curbs?
So, I'm going to have to go back to my Uncle Ben on this one.
I'm going to have to say my principal.
Oh, yeah. Principal's goated.
He's going to be leaving this year, and it's very sad. That's all I'll say, but he's a great mentor, and, yeah, he's just a good, happy person. So, have you ever taken a leap of faith or made a bold decision that completely changed the trajectory of your life?
What are these questions? I'm not thinking that far back, bro.
Okay, I swear this is real. Okay.
But... I actually have access to the Trio email now, so I can text it. I can check.
Yeah. I just realized that. Okay, we're going to move on to the next question here.
Oh, yeah, you want me checking? Checking,
right? No, it's real, I swear. All right, next question, though. What would you do if you woke up one day and discovered that gravity no longer exists?
Did you literally just look up, like, questions?
This must have been question. This must have been a question from the gravity video. I mean, the flat earth.
You literally Googled, like, questions.
No, look, I'll send a screenshot that it's actually real. Look, here's a screenshot. It's actually real.
So. Oh, these are from Zach.
Oh.
Oh, no wonder.
Okay, well, these are actually real, so.
Yeah, I guess I'm wrong.
You're wrong.
You actually sent a screenshot, and you refused to send screenshots for the other ones, which means all the other past ones were fake.
No, that's not true.
It's true.
What would you do if gravity didn't exist, Krubs?
I'd probably float in the fucking sky. I'd probably be in the air right now.
Alright, this is a Zach moment. What would be your go-to dance move if every time you sneeze, you had to break into a spontaneous dance?
What does he want me to say? Like, best mates from Fortnite? Right? He wants me to fucking, like, bro. Default dance.
Okay, I'm gonna have to say for the dance move one, the dab. It's basically you sneezing anyway, you know what I mean?
If I see you dab in public.
Yeah, but this is every time you sneeze, so it kind of fits. So it's quick and easy.
Yeah. If you just sneeze and then dab, like, that'd just be so stupid.
If you could have a conversation with any animal.
I'd like to hit the gritty, actually.
No. Oh, yeah, I saw Zach doing the gritty.
Dude.
If you could have a conversation with any animal, Curbs, which one would you choose and what would you ask them?
Any animal. I'd probably...
I'd say a spider and say, why the hell are you in my house?
A mosquito, and I'd just say, why the hell do you keep sucking me, man?
If you had the ability to teleport anywhere in the world, but could only wear a chicken costume while doing so. What the
fuck is this question? What
the fuck? Where would you teleport first?
In a chicken costume?
Zach, no way.
Tucky. You know, they love their chicken down there.
I would have to go to Ohio, bro. That's just what I would say.
Teleport to, like, Baghdad and get shot down in a chicken costume.
If you could... Alright, last question, Curbs. If you could travel back in time and convince dinosaurs to wear socks, how do you think that would have affected human history?
I swear. Wear socks?
This can't be a real question, Zach.
Dinosaurs, they got a big-ass foot. I don't think that's gonna fit, man.
If you could travel back in time, convince dinosaurs to wear socks, what do you think? How do you think it would affect human history? I don't know.
I'd probably become black, honestly. I'd probably switch races.
Well, maybe at that point, they would survive because they would have socks on. And if you have socks on, you survive.
Yeah, they're like, I have protection.
But yeah.
We don't exist.
What a great questions coming in today.
At least
send us questions at triomecraft@gmail.com. This is how the segment's supposed to be. It was fun. Yeah.
We haven't had actual questions since like the first episode.
Keep sending us questions. I don't care who you are. You could be Zach. But thank you. triomecraft@gmail.com. That's going to do it for today's episode. Curbs, any final thoughts today?
How's my mic sound?
It's all right. Buy Trail merch so we could get him a mic interface, okay? He has a mic, but he doesn't have an interface. So thank you guys for watching. Smash like and subscribe.
And ring that bell. Make sure you get notifications for the next
before
video.
We end, check out Trio Gaming, guys. It's a brand new Trio channel.
Oh, yeah.
How could I forget?
I should have talked about that more.
We're going to be making gaming videos on the Trio channel. Posting old videos first, guys, because we have them, so they might be a bit cringe, but go check them out. Link in the description, and have a good night.